Howdy, y'all. I mean, alrighty, let's get this started, because we have a vertical construction update. I'm back from the fake trip to the Yukon, blah, blah, blah. But we have some really exciting news. I had to come back and make a video. We weren't going to make a video with my voice until the announcement, just for some cheesy effect, I guess. But here I am. I have to make a video. Vertical construction is going really fast, and I was like, I can't miss out on the this whole process of describing what's going on. So while I was here today, they installed two massive I-beams for the transfer shed and track area. I'm assuming those two beams are actually the transfer track itself. It'll move along there like you see on Behemoth and Leviathan and most coasters. And then you have these weird I-beam supports used for the station. So at the end of this video, you'll see the process of the station piece itself with the combs installed, being moved and moved a little closer to where they're going to install it and ready to be installed on Monday. From what I'm being told from people at the park that are currently there, because I had to leave early today, they left for the day. So no more is starting, but we have people there. If something does happen, I'll head back to the park immediately and get some footage. But super exciting that, you know, I left the park yesterday around 4. And there was no sign of actual vertical going on. And then I come back today and they've got two massive I-beams for the transfer track. And then they have the two triangular I-beams for the actual station bit. I thought these were weird. Comment down below if you've seen these on the station before. I always thought B&Ms used actual columns for the station and then I-beams for kind of the turnout of the station, I-beams for the transfer area and all that. But I always thought the station actually used columns. But feel free to comment down below and correct me. But nonetheless, very exciting. They're moving extremely quickly. I shot this video at exactly 11 in the morning, and this is what was done. So when I go at 11 in the morning on Monday, I expect the station to probably be in place, because these people start work, I think, at like 4:30, 5 in the morning, from what I know. This is moving really quickly. I think they definitely want to show off the station, not completed station obviously, but the station piece installed for the season pass holders event. So for those of you that don't know and are watching this video, Amusement Insiders, we are going to be at the park all day on the announcement day, August 15th. We're going to be there for the season pass holders event first thing in the morning. We're going to be doing our interviews for the for YouTube of the people involved in this project. And then we're also going to be hanging out all day as a team and with, you know, a lot of our followers and friends and stuff like that. So feel free to join us and hang out with us all day. We will all be there. I'll be there. Come hang out, meet us, and yeah, hang out. Other than that, not too much going on around the construction site. So nothing much has changed. There's no new markings. Just tree removal over in Timberwolf. I have a feeling the teaser sign did not switch over yet, but I can tell that it's going to switch over very shortly. I know there's one more teaser from what I know and can tell. So one more teaser should be revealed shortly. I'm assuming maybe Monday then. That'll be like the 2-day countdown till announcement. It'll be super exciting. I have a feeling that teaser is going to be really revealing, and I think it's a mountain range if I had to predict. But here's that station bit. So as you can tell from the clips and then from this was just filmed about 20 minutes ago. They've moved the station into place. It is ready to lift onto the I-beams. All the combs are installed. So it's definitely a floorless model dive coaster. Nothing unique that I can tell based off of the train design yet. Obviously, we won't know until announcement. They're moving really quickly. Again, I said that, but this is awesome. But the shots we're getting from the construction site, I feel, is really cool. I like that you can get all these really up-close shots of the actual building process. I feel like we haven't really had that chance in a lot of cases in other projects in the past. And I look forward to documenting this construction project. We are getting our drone ready. So next week we'll start drone footage again, first thing in the morning, grabbing shots of vertical construction. That'll be super cool to document with the drone, you know, as the coaster is being built. So stay tuned for that as well. And comment down below, what do you guys think the name of this coaster is going to be? I want to hear from you. As we're getting closer, what do you think the height's going to be as well? Do you think it's going to be 213 feet tall with a 255-foot drop? Or do you think it's going to be something else? All right. Look forward to hearing from you guys down below. I'm glad to be back. It was really hard to not make voiceovers, so super glad to be back. Have a good one, guys. See you on Monday's video update. Bye.